Hello everyone, if you are enjoying machine learning model now, you might heard about KL divergence and maybe it is the best time to brush up the KL divergence. The key concept is very easy. If you are training your supervised learning machine learning model, you should have the trained dataset which is true label sample data. I denoted this true label as blue bar chart here. And let's suppose we have two machine learning models, A and B, having green color and orange color respectively. Can you say which machine learning model is better from this chart? Well, let's take a step back, and if we have the perfect machine learning model predicted just exactly the same as the true label, you will see there is zero difference between the true label distribution and the model's prediction distribution here. And now, let's take a look blue and green bar chart here. They look similar, but there are small differences between them. Relatively, you can see there is a big difference between the true label and the machine learning model B's prediction here. Well, we know model A has better prediction since model A has relatively less difference than the model B, but rather than saying small difference or big difference here, can we have a quantitative number representing the specific difference? Yes, and the number is the KL divergence. Let's denote the true label, true probability as P and the predictions as Q. So model A's prediction is QA and the model B's prediction is QB. KL divergence from the P to P is zero since there is no difference between the same probability distribution. And you now can see exact quantitative number for KL divergence from the P to QA and the KL divergence P to QB here. Since KL divergence from the P to QA is less, we can say QA, which is machine learning model A's prediction, is similar to the true label distribution. Hence, we can say machine learning model A has better prediction. Okay, that was the basic of the KL divergence, and I know you want to know more on the KL divergence, so let's get it more. KL divergence from the true labels to the predictions represents how much the model prediction is relatively different from the true label distribution. In other words, the KL divergence is relative entropy of true label with respect to prediction. We know the entropy is the number of bits to store information, so we can say the KL divergence, as known as the relative entropy, is the expected number of the extra bits required code samples of the true labels using a code optimizer for the prediction. How can we get the number of the extra bits? We have learned the cross entropy from the previous video that the cross entropy is the number of bits for the exact bit plus extra bit, and that is why the cross entropy is equal or greater than the entropy. Entropy stands for the exact bit for the information, so we can simply get the extra bit by calculating cross entropy minus entropy. So we can come up with the KL divergence equation just like here. There are two more key features of the KL divergence. First, the KL divergence always have 0 or greater than 0 value. This is because cross entropy or entropy always have 0 or greater than 0 value. Secondly, the KL divergence is asymmetric. This is also because cross entropy P and Q is different from the cross entropy Q and P. Bonus, if you are familiar with deep learning model training, you know, we use the cross entropy as cost function and minimizing it as optimization. Why don't you minimize the KL divergence instead of the cross entropy then? Because minimizing KL divergence meaning that maximizing likelihood with the true label. That is a great question and you are right. That is a good idea and you know what, you are already doing that. If we take a look at the KL divergence equation, it is just cross entropy minus entropy, while the entropy is constant and doesn't change with the model parameter during the training, and can be disregarded in the loss function. So minimizing cross entropy is actually the same with the minimizing KL divergence. Here is one more bonus. Why the name is KL divergence? Well, the KL divergence stands for Kullback-Leibler divergence, is named after the Kullback and the Leibler who introduced this algorithm. Well, thanks for watching and I hope this video helped you enjoying the KL divergence.